Hello YouTubers, welcome back to Crossxpollination. Well, today, my top band of all time, yes, it should be no surprise that Alan White comes in number 3 of our top 5 all-time rock drummers. Number 3 of 5 of all-time favorite rock drummers. That should also prove too that I'm non-biased, because he would be number 1 since that's my favorite rock band. Alan White, an amazing drummer who stepped in to fill very tough shoes, Bill Bruford, in 1972. He performs well in many different styles of Yes. He also performed with John Lennon, Ginger Baker, Joe Cocker, The Ventures, Steve Winwood. Alan White is an amazing drummer, and we're going to show you a couple reasons why I chose him this week. But because I have a broken wrist, I'm not going to be trying to emulate his playing. It's just too hard. Alan White grew up in England, learning to play piano as well as drums. As a matter of fact, by the time, well, he was young, he was also playing in piano bars, and he would play piano music, which is why we picked him being a great musical drummer. We're going to play a song that you can hear him play the marimba on, along with the drums. And this song doesn't really happen. He plays the marimba along with Steve Howe's melodic guitar playing. So he plays right alongside of what Steve Howe is doing. And he's also laying down a great drum groove. Does It Really Happen came off of an obscure album, I think in 1981, called Drama. Another obscure album features one of his best performances, Tormato, or Tomato, as other people call it. In the song Release, he does a drum solo. Now, for most part, I've been staying away from drum solos with rock drummers because so many of them are so different, and it doesn't make a great drummer, it just makes a good soloist. However, in this case, I want to show you Alan White's drum solo, because I want you to hear it side by side with Philly Joe Jones's drum solo. I think you can hear the influence, and that would be of no surprise, since from 1967 to 1969, Philly Joe Jones left America to go teach at a very prestigious school in London, near Alan White's home, and he was very influential on the then Beatles drummer's style. So you can hear some of that come through. There's no record that Alan White took lessons from Philly Joe Jones, but the influence is there.
Well, thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button below, share with your friends and musicians. I make new videos each week, so ring that bell to subscribe and receive the latest of my videos and notifications.